Hello, hello, guys. Here we have a Dell laptop standing on, but we have nothing on the screen. There is no display at all. Anyway, I went through this board, guys. I checked almost everything. I couldn't find the problem until I realized that the issue is coming from where? From the PCH. The PCH is the one causing the main problem. So what I did was I even tried to fresh the EC and then to program the main BIOS on the other side of the board, but it didn't work. Still, I'm having the same issue. Anyway, let me show it to you. Okay, there we are. We have a charger, connect a charger, right? And then let's press a power button. Just observe the fan. The fan is spinning and we have nothing on the screen. There is no display. The PCH is getting extremely hot. Let's check some fuel measurements. Take your meter, make sure it's on. Right, connect one probe to ground. Right, now let's check the PCH. We have 1.05 volts, and let's look for 3.3. you can even check here on top of the PCH. We have the 3.3, guys. We have the 3.3 and we have 1.05 volts, of which is needed for PCH, right? 1.8 volts. All right, let's check the RAM. You can even check on top of the RAM. Yes, 1.5 volts for a RAM. And then let's check the 3.3. 3.3 is there. 5 volts is there. 19 volts is there, obvious. 1.8 volts is there, of which in our case it's 1.9. Now let's check the CPU. CPU is there. Okay, anyway, guys, we have all the power, but the PCH is getting extremely hot. All right, let's use the microscope. Okay, guys, here we are. We have a PCH here. Let me show it to you. Okay, there it is. Anyway, why this is so important, let's have a look at the schematic. Okay, here we are. We have a PCH here, and there's the power. It's 1.05 volts and we were receiving 1.05 volts, right? And again, you can see that the PCH work with what? With 3 volts. And we did check, there was 3.3 volts, right? But somewhere, it's getting extremely hot. The PCH, as you can see, is controls what? The SATA, of which it's the hard drive. Right, it does so many things. I won't lie to you. Even the real time clock is also responsible for real time clock. What else? The USB, obvious. The USBs, it's controls the USBs. Okay, it works with the USBs as well. So even with the display, for the system to boot up your PCH, it should work. Okay. Called the platform control hub. It does so many things. somewhere along the line, it's getting extremely hot. I don't know what is being shorted, but something inside it's shorted with something, and it's end up causing too much heat, of which I can't do a thing except removing the whole PCH and then do repolling. And I won't lie to you guys, doing a repolling is not one of my things. It's one of the things that I don't usually do. I don't like repolling and some other stuff. It's time consuming, and maybe one day I will do a video doing a repolling, but not one of my best things. All right, I don't like to do such jobs. So let's connect the charger. Let's go back and connect the charger, and I want you to see. Okay, have a look at this. I'm gonna put alcohol there on top, and then you observe. Okay, just observe. Let me connect the charger. Charger is connected. Now let's have a look. Let me press the power button. Check there. See how the alcohol is spinning. See, it's evaporate very, 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 very fast. All of it, it's gone. Right after pressing the power button. Yeah. Guys, this is getting extremely hot. Okay, anyway, let's stop. Yeah, anyway, this is how you confirm. Alright, this is how you confirm. But one more important thing. Let's go to a schematic as well. There's the schematic, okay, for the PCH. You can check around, check some points, check 3.3 volts. Check 1.05 volt if it's there, or if there's a short there. In my case, there's no short, but something within the PCH is getting extremely hot. It's not the entire PCH. As you can see, there's a section for USB, section for real-time clock, section for PCI, section for SATA, different sections. Okay, so what is going on here? A certain section is getting extremely hot, which end up affecting the whole PCH. Anyway, guys, I hope you are getting this thing. I hope you are learning this thing. This is just a short video to give you a clue and some tips when diagnosing some motherboard. Anyway, sharp.